Hi, I'm Reverend Grant Schnarr, and welcome to Convocation. Now, you might, if you're new here, ask, what is Convocation? And usually what Convocation is, it's a gathering of everybody over at the Mitchell Performing Arts Center where we open up the year. There's a message, there's some special music, and just a great time for everybody to come together. Can't do that this year, not with COVID, so we're doing this here right now, and it's gonna be special. We have special music by our very own Jonathan Carr, backed up by Max Nelson and the new lineup for the Bryn Athyn College Band. And also I'm gonna be giving a talk, and that talk is probably on one of the most important subjects that we have, and that is learning to love one another. It's gonna be key this year. So anyway, welcome to Convocation. I wanna talk about love, and the first thing I wanna say is everybody wants to be loved. I mean, think about that. I'm talking about romantic love, but also love from family members, love of friends, being valued, being cared about. It means something to every one of us. Now, you know, it's interesting because Bryn Athyn College, one of the things that people say they love so much about it is that they feel connected. They can connect more deeply than some huge school, that people seem to just take a little more time to say hello, get to know one another. And that's a component of building love. And I think it's something that we could always do better, but it's something that we have an opportunity to do here. Now, at the same time, there's real challenges with that, right? I mean, you want to be loved, but at the same time, how do you get that? You know, and it's interesting because the Lord says, you want to be loved? Well, then love other people. You know, give and it will be given unto you. So there's a dual thing going on here. The more we learn to love others, to give, the more love we receive, the more love we get. I love it when the Lord says, give and it will be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over will be put into your heart. And I don't even know what that means. I mean, back in his day, but for me, I'm seeing, you know, like some championship game in the locker room, they're shaking up the bottles and they're spraying everybody and that, everything's just happy and joyous. Now I know that's not what the Lord meant, but you know, that idea, just you give a little bit, it just comes back to you so much. And so that's what I really want to focus on for this year at Bryn Athyn College, our experience here. It's about connection. It's about love. It's about loving one another. That's how the Lord says that we are his disciples, or how people recognize us if we love one another, recognize us as being his disciples. He says this is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to then lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends, he says. So just a beautiful thing. We know the Lord did lay down his life for us and then pick it up again. But for us, that means making that sacrifice of not wanting to be selfish, of wanting to do things our way, of wanting people only to listen to what we have to say and not listen to others. The Lord is saying, you really want to love people? Lay that down. Become a good listener. Look at it from the other person's point of view. Learn to love. Now, it's easy to say that, but what does that really mean? I mean, like, I could say, okay, I'm gonna start loving people now. What do? Hey, I love you, man. Or, oh, I love you too. And I love you. It just doesn't work that way. It doesn't come out that way. And so the Lord teaches us, you know, how to love, how to start loving one another. And another thing that he says that fits right in here is to do unto others as you would have them do to you. You know, do to others, act toward others how you would like people to act toward you. That's the beginning of learning how to love, and how we could create something here among ourselves, but also just create something in our own lives that's so special if we learn how to do that. So how do we do that? I've got three ways I want you to think about doing that. And the first one is to actually learn to see people. I mean, really, to see through the appearance and see the real person. You know, Martin Luther King Jr. talked about judging people by their character, not by their outward appearance. And the Lord talks about that too, that God sees through what we look like into our hearts. And that's what the Lord wants for us in the way of first starting to love one another is to really see the person, see the good person that is our neighbor. Everyone we see, they have something good inside of them. And do we open our eyes to be able to actually see that in people? In indigenous South African culture, there's a greeting that is, they say, Sawubona. And that means, I see you. And in the deepest context, it's such a beautiful thing. It's not just like, you know, there you are, whatever, but I see you. I see inside of you. I see who you really are inside. I see your soul. In Hindu, there's a saying, it's namaste. Now, namaste means I bow to you, very literally. But in a deeper spiritual meaning, namaste means, now go with me on this, the God in me acknowledges or bows to the God in you. Now, I interpret that to mean the good in me acknowledges and honors the good inside of you. And Swedenborg does say when we love the good in people, we're loving God in people. I'm not God, but I sure hope God is flowing through me in that goodness, and the same for you. So just imagine that's the beginning. If somebody really saw you for who you really are, or people really made that effort, and it, you to do the same to others, how what love would just start to grow. Now, secondly, to value other people. I mean, it's one thing I see you, but also to value every person, to realize every person that you know, every person you see, whether it's on, you know, Instagram, Facebook, or television, has good in them, and to value that good. Some people we're going to get to know so well that we believe that they're worth, they're priceless. I couldn't say my relationship with you is worth $1 million. It's priceless. And when we can look at everybody inside and just really see, they're priceless. God loves them. God put them here. God gave them something that nobody else can do in this world. And simply just to see that and say, recognize that that's true. What a difference that makes. Not only do I see you, but I value you and who you are. And if you do those things, you're going to come to the third one on my list right away, and that is to care for people. Not only to value, but actually to take those steps to care. I'll be with you in the hard times. I'll be with you in the good times. I will watch your back. I will be there when you cry. I will listen for you. I will pick you up when you need to be picked up. And I will call you on your stuff when you need to be called out, but I will do it with love. And just imagine, again, what your relationships would be if you put that into action. And really took the steps, you know, to care about those people that you're with every day. So that's what I think that we can have here. I mean, we have challenging times. Of course, we can do things so much better here at Bryn Athyn College, and we're working on it. And you're working on it too, right? We're all trying to come together in these times where we can't even smile at each other without with a mask on. You can't see me smiling. We gotta learn to smile with our eyes. We gotta learn to smile with our actions, and we have to learn to smile with our words. And if we do that, we're gonna make it through this challenging time together, and we're gonna come out the other side, and we could say, if we learn to love one another, this was the best term, the best year I've ever had. And if we learn to do that in our daily lives, we're gonna say, this has been an awesome and continues to be an awesome life. Love one another as I have loved you. By this, all will know that you are my disciples. If you have love for one another. Thank you.
Love is but a song we sing. And the one that's left is here. returns for us at last. We are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. Come on, people now, sister, brother, everybody get together, try to love one another. Sister, brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. You hold the key to love and fear, all in your trembling hand. Just one key unlocks them both, it's there at your command. Come on, people now, sister and brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Come on, people now, sister, brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right now. Come on, people now, sister, brother, everybody.